Good morning and a warm welcome to the students of Srimati R.S. Karadiya Primary School English Medium Junagadh. Today we are going to study about a very interesting topic of 8th standard, that is of the history, and the chapter name is Independent India. Now already we have studied about the European countries, whosoever came to our country India with the intention of the trade, French, Portuguese, Dutch, Britishers, whosoever came to our country India with the intention of this trade. But slowly and gradually they come to realize, they come to understand, as we don't have unity in ourselves, they started ruling in our country India. Among all the European countries, most European countries who stayed in our country India, who ruled in our country India, that were the Britishers. They just stayed in our country India for more than 200 years, and from year 1857 to 1947 they ruled in our country India. When they were ruling in our country India, as Indians we were not getting any of the rights, and most probably all the rights were in the hands of the Britishers. So we got independence on 15th August 1947. And in the previous chapter I have explained you that after the independence also we were have to face the three challenges. The three challenges were that to make the India as a strong Indian constitution, to give the rehabilitation to 80 lakh refugees, apart from that to have the 562 princely state into the single Indian Union. So here already in the previous chapter we have studied about the and the three challenges which was being in our country India was being solved out by the prominent leaders of our country India. Now we got independence on 15th August 1947, but we started forming for our constitution in the year 1946. We completed forming our Indian constitution on December 1949, but we started working on our constitution on 26 January 1930. The day 26 January reminds us the oath which was being taken by Jawaharlal Nehru along with the prominent leaders, and because to remember this day we have started working on our constitution on 26 January 1950. Now in the year 1920, when the Britishers were in our country India, the prominent leaders, Muslim League and the Hindu people, INC, that was Indian National Congress, promised the people that India after the independence going to be divided on the basis of linguistic, that means on the languages. But when the situation in the year 1947, when we got independence from the hands of the Britishers, during that time the situation was completely out of control. People, Hindu and the Muslim people, were fighting on the basis of communal views. There was the situation of the fight of the communal views between Hindus and Muslims was completely out of control. And we got independence on 15th August 1947, and before one day itself, that was on 14th August 1947, there was the partition of India and Pakistan on the basis of communal views. So the promise which was being given by the prominent leaders in the year 1920 to the people of our country India was not to be done by the seeing the situation of this particular partition of India and Pakistan. So let us see here, formation and reorganization of the states. India became independent and the princely states were merged into the union, that was the Indian Union. 562 princely states, 555 states were the states who were the part of the Indian Union, but the three states, that was Hyderabad, Kashmir and Junagadh, were the states were not willing to join that Indian Union. But later on, with the intelligence, with the knowledge of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, they also joined our Indian Union. Now we have adopted a federal system where each and every person is going to get the rights reserved by the government, system of the government. Hence there arose the question of forming the states as the major component of the Union of India. So India, the union that merged out this particular the merger of the British India and the princely state were classified into group A, B, C, D. So India, which was being merged with the 562 princely state, that was being divided into four parts: group A, group B, group C, and group D. This status of all the states in these four categories were not the same, though they all were in the integral part of the Indian Union. The particular partition, the particular groupism of the four parts, that was group A, B, C, and D, were not equal, but they were the integral part of the Indian constitution. Now, people from Madras, they were belonging to group A, launched a strong protest to form Andhra Pradesh for Telugu speaking community, and the government accepted their demand. Now here the Madras, the group A in that particular Andhra Pradesh people, just opposed to have the Madras and Andhra Pradesh to be partitioned on the basis of the language, that is the Telugu. So this Indian constitution accepted the particular thing, proposal of Madras and Andhra Pradesh to be partitioned, to be divided on the basis of the languages. So on 1st October 1953, the first state which was divided on the basis of the linguistic, on the basis of the language. So on 1st October 1953, Andhra Pradesh was formed as a new state on linguistic basis. So yes, it was being started by one state and the government was agreed with the particular decision. Other state also desired to have the particular distribution or the partition of the particular state on the basis of the languages. In December, within the 2 months, the people started opposing against the government on the basis the state should be formed on the basis of the languages. So on December 1953, Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru appointed the State Reorganization Committee to reorganize the Indian state. Already after the independence, the constitution started forming, working on our constitution. India was divided into four groups, group A, B, C, and D. But on 1st October 1953, as Madras was being separated on the basis of languages from Andhra Pradesh, the people whosoever were belonging to the different languages, they started opposing, and Jawaharlal Nehru, the Prime Minister of our country India, decided to form the particular state on the basis of the languages. Now, the responsibility to form the state on the basis of the languages was given to the retired Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, that was known as Faisal Ali. And this person, as the commission, was known as Faisal Ali Commission. This retired Chief Justice was given the responsibility to divide the states on the basis of the languages. The bill regarding the reorganization of the states was passed in the parliament and was implemented on 1st November 1956. So it takes 3 years to complete it, from the December 1953 to 1st November 1953. It takes 3 years to make the India on the basis of the languages. 14 states, after the states reorganization committee, 14 states were being formed up along with the 6 union territories on the basis of the languages. Only the 2 states, that was Punjab and Bombay, was declared as the bilingual state. Bilingual state means a state where there is one state but the 2 language people are living together, that is known as the bilingual state. So here 14 states and 6 union territories were being divided on the basis of languages, while Punjab and Bombay were our 2 states which were being declared as the bilingual state, where one state but the 2 language people are living together, and this was the reason for the another states to be formed out. Now here, Maha Gujarat movement. Now already we have studied that on year 1956, there was with the particular corporation and with a support of Jawaharlal Nehru, Faisal Ali Khan. Faisal Ali just formed a Faisal Ali Commission in which the states were divided on the basis of the languages. So in the year 1956, 14 states and 6 union territories were being formed. Only the two states, that was Punjab and Bombay, was declared as the bilingual state. Now we the Gujarati, the Gujarat state was before the year 1960 was a part of the Bombay. The two languages people, that was Maharashtrian and the Gujarati people, were living in a part of the Bombay state. So there was a need, the people, the Gujarati people decided that as other states are being divided on the basis of the languages, Gujarat should also be separated on the basis of the languages, and by this way the Maha Gujarat movement was being started. The day when the bilingual means a state with the two languages people recommendation for the state of Bombay was passed in the parliament, a group of the students of Low College in Ahmedabad organized a meeting and they started having a series of demonstration. Now as the other states were being divided on the basis of the languages, on the basis of the linguistic, Gujarat and the Gujarati people also want to have a separate state from the Bombay, that is from the Maharashtra, Mumbai. Now here Indulal Yagne, the promoter of Maha Gujarat movement. Many of the prominent leaders, Indulal Yagne, Brahma Kumar Bhatt, and many of the prominent leaders, they joined for the separation of Gujarat from the part of the Bombay. Now here, Maha Gujarat Janata Parishad was formed under the leadership of Indulal Yagne on September 1956 with the support of the few political parties, This Parishad demanded for the separate Gujarat state. They would observe a bandh or a strike during the meetings of the national leaders. Now Indulal Yagne was a person who became very popular in this Maha Gujarat Janata Parishad or Maha Gujarat movement, and people used to see him with the chacha of Janata. So it was now the Gujarati people was having only one way, only one intention to separate the part of the particular Gujarati people and have to just have the Gujarat state from the part of the Bombay. So the particular movement was being started on September 1956, and now in the year 1960 there was the formation of the Gujarat state from the part of the Bombay. Now let us see here how was the formation of the to separate Gujarat from the part of Bombay. We have started Maha Gujarat movement. For 4 years we have worked out to separate Gujarat from the Bombay. Now how was the formation of the Gujarat? The movement compelled the parliament to divide the bilingual state of Bombay into two parts, that was Gujarat and the Maharashtra. Gujarat was belonging to the Gujarati people languages and Maharashtra was belonging to the Marathi language people. So Bombay was being divided into two parts, that was Bombay and the Maharashtra. In the year 1960, the new state of Gujarat was inaugurated by the honorable person Ravi Shankar Maharaj. Ravi Shankar Maharaj blessed the people of Gujarat and to start the new mandal of Gujarat at the banks of Sabarmati Ashram, that was in Ahmedabad, on 1st May 1960. Ravi Shankar Maharaj, along with the inauguration of the new state of Gujarat, that was in the year 1960, he just suggested the people to not to stop the use of the Sabarmati Ashram because it was a lovable place for Gandhiji, and Gandhiji was a person, native place of the birth of Gandhiji is in Porbandar, Gujarat. So Gandhiji was having a very good attachment with the Sabarmati Ashram that was in Ahmedabad. Now here, Mehdi Nawaz Jung became the first governor of our Gujarat, and Dr. Jeevaram Mehta became the first chief minister of our Gujarat, along with inaugurating Ravi Shankar Maharaj have just instructed people that of Gujarat that you are the future generation of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel and Mahatma Gandhi. These two people always just follow the path of truth and non-violence. They always desire to maintain the peace and security among the people. Along with this, he just suggested that we are separated. Maharashtra or many states are separated on the basis of the languages, but we all are together. We are all going to live together because India is known as the land of the diversity. So we are divided on the basis of the languages, but it's our formal duty to work out together as a land of diversity. Now here, integration of the Pondicherry. Now all the European countries, the Portuguese, Dutch, French, British, came to our country India. The first European country who came to our country India were the Portuguese, and the last were the French people who came to our country India. But Portuguese were the first people to enter our country India, and leaving our country India were the Portuguese people. Now here, the Britishers leave from our country India in the year 1947, but still also French and the Portuguese were coming. This European country were ruling in our country India to some of the part of our country India. So first of all, let us study about the French community, French European country were just handling some of the part of the country India. Now Pondicherry, Calicut that is Tamil Nadu, Ma that is Kerala, Yanam that is Andhra Pradesh, and Chandranagar that is West Bengal were under the French control. People in the Nawab, this Junagadh, Hyderabad, Kashmir, as the people, the Nawab and the king don't want to join the Indian Union, but this people was very eager to join the Indian Union. So the five states which was being handled by the French people of this colonies wanted to join the Indian Union, for which they launched movements too. In the year 1948, after the independence, a huge gathering of people in Pondicherry declared quit India for the French authority. Finally, a talks and a negotiation was held between the Indian Union and the French authority, and finally the French decided to leave from the part of the country India. And finally the French government agreed on 31st October 1954. It was being started from the year 1948. After a few years, it was on 31st October 1954, this all colonies were being surrendered by the French colonies, and by this way Portuguese, Calicut that is Tamil Nadu, Ma that is Kerala, Yanam that is Andhra Pradesh, and Chandranagar that is West Bengal, which was being controlled by the French colony, were being handed over to the Indian Union on 31st October 1954. Now the last European country was still staying in our country India and controlling the three main territories of our country India, that was Diu, Daman and Goa. Now here, the integration, how we got Diu, Daman and Goa from the Portuguese people. Comparing with the French people, the Portuguese people were more adamant than the French people. Here there was no need to have a fight with the French authority. They with the talk, with the negotiation, was agreed to give these five parts of our country India. But Portuguese were more adamant than the French people. For them, Goa was a symbol of prestige, and they were never agreed to give the Goa, Diu, Daman to the Union Territory of our country India. All negotiation and talks to this colonies to India was completely failed. Like the French people, first the Indian Union decided to have a talk and a negotiation with the Portuguese people that was completely failed with this particular people. On the other side, the movements to integrate Goa into the Indian Union become more and more violent day by day because people want to join the Indian Union, and because of that only they were having the continuous fight and having a particular oppose against the Portuguese people. On 15th August 1955, 3,000 to 5,000 unarmed Indian activists attempted to enter Goa at 6 locations and were violently repulsed by Portuguese police officers, resulting into the death around 200 people. As 3,000 to 5,000 people entered, activists entered the part of Goa in which the Portuguese police officers just had the firing, and within this firing 200 people were being dead. Now here, when talks and satyagraha was completely failed, the Indian government just decided to make racial step and they launched the Operation Vijay to free Goa. Now this particular responsibility, the military operation started on the midnight. It is one type of surgical strike done by the people, the leaders of Armed for India. It was being started at the midnight of 17th and on 18th December 1961 at a noon time. We just freed the Goa from the hands of the Portuguese people under the leadership of General Chaudhary. Apart from that, after getting the help to free our Goa from the hands of the Portuguese people, the flag was being unfurled, Indian flag was unfurled on the part of the Goa. So Diu, Daman and Goa, which was the particular part being handled by the Portuguese people slowly and gradually, and with a last operation, that was Operation Vijay, with the under the leadership of General Chaudhary, we got from the Portuguese people. Diu, Daman and Goa. Goa become the state later on, and Diu, Daman become the territory of the country India. Now here, relationship of India and Pakistan. Now before the independence only, there was a bitter relation of India and Pakistani people. Hindu and Muslim community were fighting on the basis of the communal rights. They were fighting, as their Muslim people were always admiring that never ever in the country India we are going to get the benefits from the government. So on 15th August 1947 we got independence from the hands of the Britishers. Before one day itself, that was on 14th August 1947, there was the partition of India and Pakistan. Before the independence and after the independence, and still also we are having the complete bitter relation with one another. And the one issue that played a vital role for adding a fuel in the fire, that is the issue of Kashmir. They want the complete Kashmir from India, and we Indians want the some part of the Kashmir which is in the end with the Pakistani people to the country India. Now we were having the three wars with one another. That was in the year 1948, immediately after the independence, in the year 1965, and in the year 1971. Many a time we are having the agreements with one another. The two agreements I want to tell you, Tuscan Agreement and Shimla Agreement. Most probably, never ever we, the Indians or the Hindu people, are ready to have a fight with the Pakistani people, the Muslim people. But most probably, after the agreement also, the first fight always start from the side of the Pakistani people. In the year 1999, there was a Kargil war, and during that time also we have defeated them with a very intelligence, but many of our soldiers were died in the Kargil war. Apart from that, in the year 1998, we were having the nuclear weapons. Along with the nuclear weapons in India, there is a nuclear weapon in the Pakistan. So we are always desiring, India is always desiring to have a friendly relation with the Pakistani people, but there should be a cooperation of the two community together. If the one community is thinking, the other should also cooperate for the same thing. Here India today. Now before the independence and after the independence, there was a drastic change in our country India. When we got India from the hands of the Britishers, our economic system, social, political was completely ruined. Now comparing with that particular independence of more than 70 years, we have developed a lot. Today implementation of 5-year plans make the age of industrial development in India in the true sense. When we got India from the hands of the Britishers, our India was completely real. More than 70 years of the independence, India is developed a lot. Notable development has happened in the cotton textile, sugar, iron and steel, engineering, chemical industries and coal mining. Many critics. Now, along with that, we have also developed a very good remarkable things in the technology, science and technology. With the latest things, we are developing more. We are using the many of these scientific technological things in the agriculture, trade, industry there. Comparing with the early ages, now we are having the latest technology in our country, India. When we got India from the hands of the Britishers during that time, our situation was completely zero. After 70 years or more than 70 years of independence, we have developed from the zero of the economic system, social, political. We are in the category of the developing nation. Now many of the people who are always, who are considered to be the art critics, they are always believing that India would not be able to sustain longer as a nation and would become a militarist nation. The nation had developed in industry, science, infrastructure, agriculture, etc. Most probably the people, the particular country who were the jealous country, who were considered themselves to be the superior, challenges our country India that never ever this India is going to be developed. And the reason behind that was, first of all, we don't have unity in ourselves. We were fighting on the basis of caste, color and grade. But then also with the cooperation, with the coordination, we have supported each other, and we just from the zero we came to the category of the developing nation. Now in our country India, we the Indians are known as the land of diversity, where Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Isai, Parsi, SC, ST, OBC, general, all are living together and are working together. And India is a particular country where we are able to see a lots of different category of the people are living together and working out for the development of the nation. But on the other side, there are some of the negative points. They are playing a very important role, a massive role for just stopping the development of the nation. Though the constitution has declared India as a secular state, communal tensions is not an uncommon thing. Still also in many of the part of the country India, still also there is the discrimination on caste, color and creed. Many of the people are still as much as educated, but then also they are not stopping the particular differentiate on caste, color and creed. And a big issue for our country India, which is having the hindrance for the development of the nation, that is the differentiate between the poor and the rich. In our country India, the rich is becoming day by day riches and the poor is becoming day by day the poor person. Now most probably the rich people from the birth till the last day he is just enjoying the luxurious life, and while the poor person who was born in the slum area always end his or her life in the slum area only. So the hindrance for the development of the the nation, that is the difference, the vast difference between the rich and the poor people. Most of the facility who are getting in our country India, we are having a lots of corruption, inflation, unemployment, illiteracy in our country India. They play a very, very vital role in not developing our country India. Apart from that, we are able to see a vast difference on the basis of caste, color and creed. One of the lady who was a great follower of Gandhiji just said that day by day, one day it is after the independence on, so Madeline Sledge was a lady who just said that Meera Ben was a lady who was a disciple of Gandhiji, just said in one of the books that one day the India is going to develop, but along with its development the environment is going to destroy, because people are not going to, in the ways of the development, they are going to forward for the conservation and the reservation of the environment. So it's our moral duty. Earth is a planet where we are getting the life on the surface of the earth. So it's our moral duty, along with the development, we should take care of the environment. So here I am ending with my topic. Let us have a short summary of the chapter. Now already we have studied about the independence of the country India. We got independence on 15th August 1947. Then the three challenges were being accepted from the Britishers, that to form the political system in our country India, to merge the 562 princely state into the single union and give the rehabilitation to 80 lakh refugees. The three challenges which was being given to us was completely with a good faith we have completed. Now in this chapter we have studied that India was divided into four groups, group A, B, C, D. In the year 1st October 1953, Madras just opposed, that was the group A, that Andhra Pradesh should be separated on the basis of the languages, that is Telugu. On 1st October 1953, Andhra Pradesh and Madras was being separated on the basis of the languages, while all the other states are admired and they just opposed that if Madras and Andhra Pradesh is being separated, other states should be separated on the basis of the languages. So on 1st December 1953, Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru just gave the work to Faisal Ali to form a reorganization commission in which there should be the formation of the states on the basis of the languages. So in the year 1956, there was the formation of the state, that were 14 states and 6 union territories were being made on the basis of the languages. Only the two states, that was Punjab and Bombay, was being on the bilingual state. Bilingual state means the state which is having the two languages people together and a single state. So our Gujarati people completely opposed and they want their separate state on the basis of the languages. So on first, Indulal Yagnik was a person along with other prominent leaders started the opposing of having the separate state from the Bombay from the year 1956. After 4 years, in the year 1st May 1960, Bombay was being separated into two parts, that was Maharashtra and Gujarat. Ravi Shankar Maharaj was a person who just inaugurated our Gujarat with some of the instruction. He just said to take care of, as we were divided on the basis of the languages, but we all are united. This is the land of diversity, and the forefathers, that was Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, and this Mahatma Gandhi was a person whom the land is belonging, so we should take care of the land of the diversity. Then we have studied about the French authority, French colony who just living in our country India, but with the talks and negotiation we just moved them from our country India. The Portuguese people were more adamant than the French people. They were not having any of the way to give Goa, Diu, Daman from their hands. So there was a need, talks and satyagrahas was failed. So it was a need of the surgical strike to stop or to throw the Portuguese from Market to India on 17th midnight to 18th December 1961. There was Operation Vijay with the leadership of General Chaudhary, and within the noon of 18th December 1961, this particular state was being released from the Portuguese rule. So apart from that, we have studied about the India today. That day by day we are developing a lot. We are having the latest technology, science and technology, infrastructure, everything. Comparing with the early ages in the country India, we have developed a lot. Slowly and gradually, many critics just challenges that India never ever going to be a prosperous nation, a developing nation, but we prove ourselves to be the best. Apart from that, we have studied about the other points, the differentiate between caste, color and grade, the vast difference in the poor and the rich people. The rich people are becoming the richest, the poor are becoming the poorest. So all along with the positive things, we have studied about the negative things. So here I am ending my topic. Thank you and have a nice day.